Assalamu alaikum. Well, in this tutorial, we'll see how to make radio buttons like this, and then we'll also see how to save the value of the selected button so that you can use it later. We'll do that using GetX package. Well, to do this, first I have created a controller here and I call it buttonController.dart, and then I have extended GetX controller using this GetX package. After this, I have created a variable, string variable, and the default value is home delivery. Because we are going to work on buttons like this, where you can have a different value for each button, and we want to know which value has been selected or whether the value has been changed. So for us, the default value is home delivery, and we also set a getter for this. Then we created a method called setOrderType. So this is the method that would get called, and because this method would get called, so it'll change the value. So whatever the value being selected, that would be passed to this parameter, and then we'll save this value in this order type. So later on, we can use this order type, this getter, to get the or see the value from our changes or from the button click. And of course, this value could be also sent to your server. Now we'll go to main.dart, and over here we'll create a stateless class. Now the class name is OrderTypeButton, and it's a stateless class, and as you can see, it'll take four parameters, and we created the constructor. So we'll create two buttons. As we create the buttons, we'll send the value and the title. Among them, the most important is the value, and this is the value that we want to toggle, and this is the title. So the title would be visible, and title and value, of course, they could be different. Now these two are just for looking nice. Now here I do have a build method. Now inside this build method, we'll return a get builder so that we can make reactive button. So button would be reactive. Not only that, they'll also preserve value based on their clicking. So now here we are returning get builder, and over here for get builder, the class type is the controller. The controller is this one. So over here, we're creating an instance based on this button. So the controller instance is button controller, and we'll wrap our radio button using inkwell. Okay, so that's why we have this onTap event, and on the onTap over here, we'll call this method, which is called setOrderType, which is this one. So as we call it, we'll pass the value. So here is our radio button. As you see, there'd be a value. So whatever the value you set here, we'll also set that value for this radio button. And we also have group value. Doesn't matter how many buttons are there, only one value would be selected. Okay, all right, and that selected value would be set from this variable, which is called order type. Now once again, do remember that order type is this one, which would be set from a click event. So whatever the value has been selected, that would be given to this group of buttons. So here I have created a sized box, title, and the value. So over here we'll check if the value is a take away or free, which is a boolean, then we'll say, hey, this is free. Otherwise, we'll show the whatever the amount for this button was given, we'll divide it by 10. Okay, so now our button is ready over here. All we need to do, we need to create instance from here. So over here, I'm calling order type button two times, and each time I'm giving a different value. Whatever the value is being clicked, that would be selected in a radio button. Okay, now title could be anything. It doesn't really matter. Now for the value itself, a lot of people also might prefer a 0, 1, 2, 3. So it doesn't really matter whatever you assign here, as long as you can keep track of the value. So we are almost ready. All we need to do over here, we need to inject the controller. So here we injected the controller. Okay, now we'll run our app. Now of course, no change because this was the previous view. But as you see, as we click, of course it works. At the same time, we can print the value. Now to print the value, actually we can print from here. We'll reload our app. Now here we see the order type is takeaway. So this is the value that's been selected. Now if we click on this, we see the order type is home delivery. So what happens over here, we are creating instance or object from here. Now each time we are passing a different value, okay? So whatever the value you pass over here, so we take that value and we pass it to this function, okay? Now this function sets it over here. Yeah, that's as simple as that one. Now, of course, at the same time, this value is also given to the radio value, okay? Now that's why that certain radio button gets selected. So what do we learn over here? You use this, you call a function, you know, you set the value and you preserve the value, and this is the value that you should use for your further processing of data, whatever you want to do. So anyway, if you want to get the code of this tutorial, check out the link below. Thank you so much.